We are taught that the chamber of music is adjacent to the chamber of tshuva, of return to God, of connecting and clinging to godliness. In order to cling to God, one has to sing to God. When one sings, one returns from being something yesh to the primordial state of nothingness. Once the Alter Rebbe, the first Rebbe of Chabad, said, what is the difference between speech and song and melody? And he said that each one is a quill. He compared them to a quill. He said that speech is the quill of the heart. It fully expresses, gives expression to the heart, to the emotions of the heart, primarily to the love of the heart. But song, melody, nigun, is even a higher level than speech. It is the quill of the soul. It gives full expression to the depths of the soul. The depths of the soul are not only the conscious levels of our consciousness, our emotions and our intellect, but the depths of the soul are the unconscious, the superconscious levels of the soul. We just mentioned two words, something and nothing. To give expression to the love of the heart is to reveal, to manifest our true somethingness. Because a Jew in essence is a lover. He loves his fellow man. He loves his Torah that God has given us. He loves the land of Israel. Speech, words, give expression to that love. That's giving expression to the heart. The heart is primarily the emotion of love. But when one sings to God, and actually everything in creation sings to God, all of creation, God created something from nothing. The song to God is the motion inherent, intrinsic to every created being. And that motion itself is the passion of the created being to return to its ultimate divine source, to return from its state of nothingness to, from its state of somethingness to the primordial state of nothingness. What is that in the soul? That's the point, the innermost point of serenity, peace, and pleasure, divine pleasure. In Kabbalah, we're taught that divine pleasure is referred to as the head, the supernal head of nothingness, Risha, the Ayin. That's what we reach when we sing a melody. There are two types of melodies. One is a melody of joy, of dance. Like now we're in the festival of Sukkot, and the mitzvah, Simchat Bet HaShoeva, is to see ourselves in the temple together with the priests serving the service of the temple and the Levites, who they are the singers in the temple. And it says, when Mashiach will come speedily in our days, the Levites, the singers, will be even higher, a higher level even than the priests. And the priests will be the Levites. Because when they sing to God, they elevate all of the service, all of our divine service, all of our connection to godliness, return our ego, which is our feeling, sense of somethingness, to the primal state of nothingness. And when one returns to that state of nothingness, one experiences infinite pleasure, infinite serenity, infinite peace. We all want peace. We all strive for peace. But we don't understand and realize that peace is a state of self-nullification altogether. And that is the most pleasurable state of being imaginable. That's returning to God. How does one achieve that? Through song. Both song of joy, as we said before, and song of longing. It's called Nigunei Ga'aguim, is the term in Hebrew. That one longs to return and become one with God. And that longing, much more, that expresses not just the conscious level of the soul, but expresses the inner essence of the soul, which is the superconscious level of the soul. It's called the crown of the soul. Once more, a human being is referred to as a speaker, medaber. So the fundamental state of being human and being a Jew also is to speak words. And a Jew speaks words of love. Love to God, love to Israel, love to the Torah. But even higher than those words are the wordless songs that we sing, that everything sings. The day sings, the night sings, the sun sings, the moon sings. Every creation sings to God. And that's its life force, that's its motion. That's what keeps it in existence. That's its very existence, because in order to be alive, to exist, one has to move. It's called Chaim Mitnoea. And that motion itself is its song. We're taught that when Joshua wanted the sun and the moon to stand still in order that he complete the defeat of the enemies of Israel, he sang the song of the sun and the moon. He replaced them. As soon as he sings their song, so they can become silent. But they cannot be silent for one moment. There's not a tzaddik that is so great that he can actually sing the very song of the sun and the moon. So here we understand the great importance and service. The highest level of service of God is to sing to God. So may we all sing in longing for God, and then experience that our longing has been realized, has been actualized, and that we are coming close again. Then we begin to sing songs of exuberant joy and to clap our hands and dance with our feet, like on Simchat Torah, that the joy permeates all of the limbs of our body and reaches the bottom level, the base level, which is the dance of the feet. So may all merit to experience this and have a good and sweet year, a year of joy, a year of song.